Hello everyone, and welcome to my first January video, or Generative Art January. I'm not going to participate in every prompt, but for every worthy project I create throughout, there is going to be a quick explanation of how I made it. The first prompt I did in January is the space one. This is a fairly simple sketch where I used something that I created for the last video on color. That is this sign flower that I used to resemble an eye for the end of the video. When I saw the third prompt being space, I thought to create an animation of particles following the flower's path, because I thought it would look more like particles going in and out from the center of the screen. So let's do that. First, I'll create the particles class. I'll call it agent because a force of habit. And every agent requires position, size, and speed as usual. We'll start at a random position on a circle. For that, we'll need a radius and an angle that I'll be calling t for time, both of which are going to be random. We can use them now for x and y using sine and cosine to position them around a circle. For the size, we'll go with random. Let's display a point. I'm not going to color this for now because we want to focus on the animation more. So let's give it a stroke of white to start with. And it'll be a point with a stroke weight of size. Now in the update method, we'll move it based on the path of a sine flower. If you look at this Wikipedia page, you'll find the formula for sine flowers. So let's implement this. We'll use the same formula we used to convert a polar coordinate into our Cartesian coordinate system. The same ones we use to randomize the points around a circle at the top inside of our agents class. And it's what I use in the majority of my flow field videos, if you watched any of those. And now because we're using time as the variable name instead of angle, that will be what's inside of our sine and cosine functions. We'll simply increase it by an infinitesimal value inside of our update method. You can also use vectors and limit the velocity of that, but we'll keep it simple here. And for radius, we'll map the value of sine times 50 for the constant over here from negative 1 to 1 to 0 to width divided by 2 minus the margin. Now, I didn't do from margin to width divided by 2 minus margin because that will create a hole in the middle, because those two numbers are the inner radius and outer radius of your circle. So those two values are up to you, but for now, I'm just going to use those two values. As per usual, we'll start with one agent so you can see how the flower looks like when it's drawn. For that, I'll create an agent, and then in here, I'll display it and update it. And if I run it, we'll see that its movement is going to create the same shape that we saw in the Wikipedia page. And now that we've seen it, we can create an array of agents or particles, if you want to call it that. And of course, we can reset it either with a background or a rectangle with low transparency to create the echo. And for that, I'll just switch this from being one agent to an array of agents. You can start with 500, I'll start with 1,000, it's up to you. And then I'll create a for loop inside of the setup function to initialize each of the agents. And finally, in the draw method, I'll write a for in loop that will display and update all of these agents. And if I run this, we should see the same design that I had in the sketch. And of course, I'll link to the sketch file in the description down below. And I hope that you'll experiment with other constants from the Wikipedia page that I showed and create different movements using the other flower shapes. And just before I forget, in the sketch file, I also add the color variable for each of the agents. It's just randomizing color from a color array that I'm going to just choose for the sketch file. Feel free to choose your own colors or even color it based on its movement. So if it's closer to the center of the flower, then it has a different color. And if it's closer to the margins, then it'll have a different color. I didn't want to make this video too long by explaining things that I've explained numerous times in other videos, so I'm just going to implement it in this sketch file that you're going to download if you want. And yeah, that's pretty much it. So I hope you enjoyed this video, and I'll talk to you soon.